Hello students, today we'll be learning about math library function. Now what's a library method? The method which are created by the system developers are said to be library method or they are built-in method. Now in this video, we'll learn some of the functions of math class. The math class is an inbuilt class provided by Java and it is part of java.lang package. We don't need to write the import statement to import this package because by default java.lang is part of every class. The method of math class are static method, so we use the notation class.methodName. You need to remember this. In the class part, it is always mentioned as math, that is M-A-T-H, and then it's followed by the dot operator and you can mention the method names. Let's see the first method. The first method is the power function. It takes two arguments, A and B. The power function is used to find the result for the number raised with the power, where A is the base value and B the exponent value. The return type is always double data type. Now the first example, math.power 4,2, that is 4 raised to the power 2, the return value will be 16.0. Even if two integer values are passed, the return value is always in the double format. In the second example, math.power, two double values are there, 4.0 and 2.0. That is when 4.0 is raised to 2.0, the result will be in the double format, that is 16.0. Now, third example, 5.0, minus 2.0. So, math.power, when we raise it, as you know, it comes to the denominator part and the result is 0.4. Let us see this function practically. You can see I'm passing two integer values, 4 and 3. That is 4 raised to the power 3. I compile it in the terminal window. When you see the result, you can see 64.0. Now, supposingly, I need to find only the integer part. In that case, I'll be using the cast operator int. Now, let's compile it. You can see the difference. The default return type is always double data type. But when I use my cast operator int, in the second statement, you can see only the integer part has been returned. Let's see the next function. Math.squareRoot and math.cubeRoot. So math.squareRoot and math.cubeRoot, both of them take a single parameter. This function, the square root function, is used to find the square root of a positive number and its return type is also double type of value. So math.squareRoot 25 will give you the output 5.0. Now you need to remember this. Square root of a negative number is an imaginary number. Hence, it returns as NaN. That's a shorthand notation of not a number. Now the cube root function is used to find the cube root of a positive number. It also returns a double data type. So the cube root of 125 is 5.0. Let's see it practically. Now you can see over here. Now when I compile it, you can see the cube root of 64 is 8.0. The square root of 64 is 8.0 and the cube root of 125 is 5.0. In the similar way, if I don't need to find only the integer part, you need to use the cast operator int. So when I'll compile it now, you can see in the first statement, in the output you can see, for the first statement, only 8, the integer part has been displayed. Whereas in the second statement where no cast operator is used, the default data type is double, so 8.0 has been displayed. So the default return type of cube root and square root function is double. So if you need to find only the integer part, then you need to use the cast operator int. Let's see the next function. Math.min and math.max. Both of them, they take two arguments. They can take only two arguments. What is the use of the min function? The function is to return the minimum of two numbers. The return value depends on the value used as argument for the function. That is, if you pass integer value, the output will be in integer format. If you pass double value, the output will be in double format. If you pass an integer and a double value, the result will be in the double format. Now you can see in the first example, I am finding the minimum between 8 and 12. That is 8. So the result is 8. Now you need to know, suppose I need to check between three numbers. That is 5, 4 and 3, which is the minimum value. In that case, we can write in this way, mat.min. Within bracket, first argument I write 5, comma, in the next argument place, I write again the mat.min function passing 4 and 3. So what will be the result? That is between 4 and 3, the minimum result is 3. So the next comparison will be between 5 and 3 and the output will come as 3. So the minimum function can take only two arguments as at a time. So you can pass a value and you can pass an expression where you can check min function again. So you can compare three numbers at a time in this format. So when in the third example, we are passing two double values, that is negative double value. So the minimum value among them between minus 7.8 and minus 9.5 is minus 9.5. What is the role of max function? This function returns a maximum of two numbers. Now, the return value, similar way, depends on the argument passed. If I pass an integer value, the return will be an integer format, like between 8 and 12. Maximum value is 12. In a similar way, when I need to find the maximum between three numbers, then I need to write mat.max within the bracket 5, comma, again the expression I have written, mat.max, the maximum between 4 and 3. The maximum value will be 4. So again, 5 and 4 will be checked. So the maximum value 5 will be returned to me. When we compare between negative double values, the result will be a negative double value. Let's see it practically. Now you can see, at first, let's compare two integer values. You can see I am passing, let's pass the same value 9 and I'll compile it. You can see maximum is 9, minimum is 7. Let's do one thing. We'll make it double value. You can see the return type. Okay, now when I compile it, you can see the value returned. Now this is in the double format. Now suppose I need to check between three numbers. So I'll write mat.max within bracket. Now suppose I give two integer values, let's say 7 and 8. In the similar way, we can do, suppose for maximum value, for the minimum value, I can write over here, max. Suppose we pass 6, 7. Now you can see in both the questions, I'm checking between three numbers. We compile it. Now when we see the result, you can see, even though integer values are involved over here, but one of the value is in the double format. So the result will be in the double format. So you can see over here, at a time only two parameters or two values can be passed. If there is three numbers has to be checked, then again you can use the max function or the min function within that expression. Let's see the next function. The next function is mat.flow and mat.seal. Both of them can take a single argument at a time. Now, as the name suggests, seal is always the top, flow is always the bottom or the down. Now, the flow function returns down to the nearest integer. It always returns double data type. And the seal, the function returns rounded value to the next higher integer. It always returns in the double data type. Now, mat.flow 6.25, the flow value will be 6.0. The seal value will be 7.0. For flow value of 9.95, it will be 9.0. Seal value will be 9.95. But when a negative number comes, you can see the mat.flow minus 8.25, it will become minus 9.0 and the seal value will be minus 8.0. Why? Because in the number system, in the number line, if you remember, minus 9 is always towards the left hand side of minus 8.25 and minus 8 is in the right hand side. So we know in the left hand side, all the lower values are present. In the right hand side, all the higher values are present. So minus 9.0 is the highest integer, is the lowest integer of minus 8.25. Whereas in case of seal, minus 8 is the higher integer. So you get to know that when floor function for a positive number is there, you can say the integer part of that expression is there. But in case of floor, In case of a negative value, you need to remember the seal will give the integer part. Let's see it practically. Wow. You can see both the numbers. We'll compile it. You can see minus 4.45, the seal value is minus 4. In case of flow, it is minus 5.0. Suppose we make it positive, then you can see the result will be 5.0 and 4.0. Now I'll show it. We make it negative now. Now I'll compile it. We run the program. Now you can see the difference. 4.45 seal value is 5.0. 4.45 floor value is 4.0. When it becomes negative, seal becomes minus 4.0 and floor becomes minus 5.0. Let's see the next program. The next program is the absolute function. It returns the absolute value. What's the absolute value? The negative number. The sign is removed. Negative number becomes positive number. Positive number remains as positive number. Now, in the similar way, the type of value passed, the return type will be in the same format. If you pass an integer value, return type is integer. If you pass a negative value, if you pass a double value, the return type will be double. If you pass a positive number, the return value is positive. If you pass a negative number, the return value will also be positive. Let's see it practically. Now we have used my absolute function. You can see it's a double type of value. So the return value is also double. Since it's a positive number, no change. Suppose I make it negative. You can see the value returned will be positive. Let's make this one integer type of value. The return value is integer. Okay. Let's see the next method. The next method we have is round. Now this function takes a single argument and it returns a value in rounded form. That is when you pass a decimal value or a double type of value, it will give you, and this function returns an integer type of value. So it removes the fractional part of the number. it returns the, if the fractional part of the number is below 0.5, it returns the same integer value. Otherwise, it returns the next higher integer value in double type of data. You can see, suppose mat.round 5.5 will give you 6, but mat.round 5.45 will give you 5. Now, in case of negative minus 5.95, it will give you minus 6. Because, now let's see it practically. Now, before that, we can see the next function, that is bin. It is somewhat same to your round function. It returns a truncated value of a number. That is, integer part of the fractional number. When fractional part is less or equals to 0.5, it returns the integer part. And if the fractional part is more than 0.5, it returns the next higher value in double type. Now then, what is the difference between round and rint? The difference is round always returns an integer type of value, whereas rint returns a double type of value. Now let's see this practically. Now you can see over here, I'm passing two same numbers, one in round, one in rint, 4.45. I compile it. Now you can see in the output terminal window, round gives you the integer value only, whereas rint gives you the double value. Now let's make it negative and I compile it. You can see in the terminal window the result, minus 4. So round always gives an integer type of value, whereas rint gives a double type of value. Now we come to the next function, that is log and exponential. Log returns the logarithmic value of a given number and its return type is always double type of value. Exponential gives you the exponential value, that is e to the power x, it returns a double type of value. Now we come to random. Now this function returns a random number between 0 and 1. It returns, its return type is always double type of value. Now suppose the question is to get integer random numbers between 1 and n. So you need to write int. Int is the cast operator over here because the return type is always in double. Now you need to remember over here, random doesn't take any parameter. It is generated by the system. It is know where the user is concerned with it. But okay, like when we need to find random number between 1 and n, we give the limit over there. And the system will generate automatically any number. So no argument is passed over here, but the return type is always in the double type of value. So let's see practically, like the second question is integer random number between m and n, where m and n are the lower and the upper limit of the integer. So this is a syntax for it. Int is the cast operator over here. Now let's see this practically. You can... Now, suppose the first statement is to find any random number between 1 and 7. So, if I remove, let's first run this one. And the second example is to find 9 and 2 are the upper limit. So, I've written over here n minus m, n is 9, m is 2. So, upper limit is 9, lower limit is 2. When I compile it, you can see it gives me. Now if I go on compiling, see now the result, between 7 and 1 any random number, so 7 has come. Between 9 and 2 any random number, so 4 has come. So let's again compile it. Now you can see it's auto changing. We are not entering any value, it's automatically changing. Now it has become 4 and 3. Between 1 and 7 any value, so 4 and 3, 4 has come. Between 9 and 2 any value, so 3 has come. Again when we compile it, we get 5 and 2. So this is every time a new number will be given. Now what happens, suppose we remove this integer part, this cast operator, if we remove it, then you can see it will give me double type of value. So you know the difference now. When I use a cast operator, only integer value, the integer part is given to me. But when I remove it, the by default, random gives me a double type of result. So the double value is displayed over here. Let's go for the next program. Next function, method. The next method we see is sine, cos and tan. These are part of the trigonometric functions. These are used to find the sine value, cos value and tan value of a given angle in radian as an argument. So these are all the functions. Now pi, it is a variable. It is not a function, but it's in the math class. It's a static final variable defined in math class, which has a value that is very close to the value of mathematical definition of pi. That is the pi's value we know, 22 by 7, it will give us 3.14. So over here, I have taken 1 so that we get to know what's the actual value of the system. The actual value is 3.14. The system also gives the same value. We can run it in the program and we can see. You can see over here, we are using the pi variable. It's not a function. It's not a method. It's a static final variable in the math class. So when I compile it, and when we see in the output, you can see 3.141 because I've given 1 and 1 as the value. Suppose I change it to 3. This is the formula to find the area of a square circle. You can see in the output 22. So you don't need to write over there 22 by 7 as a separate variable. You can use mat.py variable in your finding the area of a circle. Now this was all about the math function. There are many more math functions, but these are the functions that are required to be covered in your ICSE syllabus. Now let's do some exercise. Now write the equivalent Java expression of the following formulas. Suppose the formula is minus, now as you know this formula, you can see minus b plus square root b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So when we put it in the Java expression format, we have to use this bracket to separate them. Within bracket, I start with minus b plus, again put a bracket, mat dot square root, again put a bracket, within that mat dot power b comma 2, that is for b square, over here minus, you cannot see, it's over here minus 4 into a into c. Now close the bracket. This was for this bracket, this is closing. Then again we are closing the bracket for the square root, and we are closing for the numerators demarcation, whole divided by 2 into a. Now the next formula that we see is cube root, that is cube root of a cube plus b cube plus c cube. So we write over here in the Java expression, mat dot cube root whole mat dot power a comma 3 plus mat dot power b comma 3 plus mat dot power c comma 3. Suppose we have this formula, 4 by 3 pi r cube. So we represent it in the Java expression as 4.0 by 3.0 into mat dot pi. This is a variable into mat dot power r comma 3. So let's see the output. The next question is, give the output of the following program segment. So double x equals to 2.0, y equals to 2.5. Now we have to print the minimum value. And we write one more function inside, that is mat.floorx. Now mat.floorx, that is 2.0. If we do the floor, it will be 2.0 only. So when we compare between 2.0 and 2.5, the minimum value is 2.0. So this is the result. Now in the similar way, system.out.println mat.max, mat.seal 2.0. So it will become 3 because the higher value is 3. So maximum between 3 and 2.5 is 3.0. So the result will be 3.0. So you understand 2.0 floor, it is itself, the integer part is 2.0. But in seal, it gets converted to 3.0. So the comparison result gives me 3.0. Now the next question is again in a similar way, mat dot we need to print the mat dot absolute within bracket mat dot minimum minus 2.83 between minus 5.83. So the minimum value between both are minus 5.83. So the minimum function will give me the result minus 5.83, but the absolute function will remove the negative sign and give me the output 5.83. The next question, system.out.println mat.round within bracket mat.absolute minus 2.3. So absolute function will remove the negative sign and giving the result 2.5. Rounding of 2.5 will give me the result 3. As you know, round gives me only in integer data type. The return type is in integer format. The third question, mat.out.println mat.print mat.max 6.35, 14.74. So between 6.35 and 14.74, the result will be 14.74. When we do the rounding off of an integer, it will come 15.0. So this is a summary of all the math functions that we have learned today. That is absolute, maximum, minimum, round, square root, cube root, power. We don't have... Then we have seal floor, random. Then we have rint, rounding of integer, sine, cos, tan, log, and exponential. So I hope you have learned from it. Thank you.